Hi, this is Susan Haynes, and we're in December, finally. I'd like to, in this couple of clips, talk about network flow on a network that has demands at some of the nodes. And the idea here is that I want to be calculating what we call maximum circulation on this network. So you see I have a graph, a directed graph of four nodes, A, B, C, and D. I have edges between some of those nodes, they're directed edges, the labeling on the edges, the capacity of that link to show how much traffic that link can bear at most. And then next to the nodes, I have a number on some of them. And in fact, in this example, I have a number against all of them, but the number that appears here refers to the demand. If I have a positive number right here, then this node is a sink, meaning this node right here demands 5 units of traffic end up here. Now I can have traffic come down this link or down this link, but the total sum of the traffic that ends up here that comes in on those two links has to equal 5. Here I have a demand of 2. It's a positive number. That means it's a sink. So I have to have 2 that end up at this node. Now coming in, I've got a capacity of 4, a capacity of 5, and going out, I have a capacity of 3. So if, for example, I were to have flow of 1 coming in and flow of 3 coming in, 1 plus 3 is 4, I could then have flow of 2 going out, and that would leave 2 behind here. A negative number means this is a source node. It's a supply. This node wants to, is required to supply 3 units of traffic flow, either down this link or down this. Okay, and similarly 4. 4 is another source node. It wants to supply, it must supply 4 units. So the source has negative number for demand, and sink has positive number for its demand. Okay, now the way we solve this problem is we convert this graph right here into another graph by adding a super source and a super sink and removing the demands. So I'm going to proceed with the next step, which is to remove demands. That is step 1. And then step 2 will be, once I remove the demands, just calculate using the Ford Fulkerson algorithm, just like normal. And then once I'm done with that, I want to go back and undo I want to replace the demands to make sure everything is copacetic. Okay, now we can see right here that I'm going to have the constraint on the circulation will be similar to what I had before. The flow along any link has to be greater than 0 or less than or greater than or equal to 0, less than or equal to the capacity. So there will be a capacity constraint on all of the links. Now before, when I did not have the demands, the sum of the flows going into a node had to equal the sum of the flows going out of the node. Here it's modified. The sum of the flows going into the node minus the sum of the flows going out of the node has to equal the demand. So we call those demand constraints. So all these constraints right here have to be satisfied in order to have a successful solution. So first step here is to remove the constraints, and the way we remove the constraints is by constructing two new nodes, S and T. I draw the rest of the graph just like it was before, except I remove the labeling of the demands. Capacities will all remain the same. Okay, now from my S node and my T node, I will add a link from S to all the source nodes, all the nodes with negative demand right there. And the capacity on those links will be the negative of the demand at those nodes. So the capacity, the demand here was minus 3 to A. The capacity of the link from S to A is labeled with the 3. And then something similar for the sinks. I've got all my sink nodes, formerly sync nodes, now point to T, and the capacity on those links equals the demand. So that's 2 and 5. Okay, I now need to go about solving the this new network right here with the Ford Fulkerson, and I'll do this rapidly and mostly in our heads rather than the step-by-step using the residual graph and all of that. I will identify the augmenting path that I'm going to use, but then I'll just go back up to this graph right here and make the modifications on the flows. Remember, these are the capacities. Those are the numbers that you see. Currently, the initial flow is zero everywhere. Okay, so the first augmenting path I can see is, let's say, SBDT. And the bottleneck on that, let's see, I've got 4, 4, and 5, so that gives me a bottleneck of 4. So I go back to my original graph and I modify my flows by adding the flow of 4 to the current flow. See, I forgot to label that one right there. I better get that labeled, huh? Okay, so now, so that takes care of that right there. Now I want to, let's see, I could go S to A, SACT gives me a bottleneck, let's see, 3, 4, 2 gives me a bottleneck of 2, so let me modify those. So there'll be a 2, 2, and 2. 0 plus 2 gives me 2. Okay, now I can have S to A to B to C to D to T. S, A, C, D, T. And SA, so that's a 1. I'm looking for the bottleneck now, so that's 1, 5, 5, 3, 1. So that gives me a 1. So this is S to A is 2 plus 1 is 3. This is A to B, isn't it? A to B. I kind of leaped over myself. So let's do S to A to C to D. Okay, we'll stick with the original. S to A to C to D to T. S to A to C to D to T. That gives me a bottleneck of 1. Okay, S to A, that's 2 plus 1 gives me 3. A to C, 2 plus 1 gives me 3. C to D, 0 plus 1 gives me 1. And D to T, 4 plus 1 gives me 5. Okay, I have nowhere I can get flow going into T here, so I am done constructing my maximum flow network right here. So let's just take a quick check on this, make sure I didn't make any mistakes. Coming out of S, I've got, S is a source, so don't worry about that. Let's check conservation right here. So coming in is 3, and going out is 0 plus 3, so that's okay. B coming in is 4, and going out is 0 plus 4. D coming in is 1 plus 4, and going out is 5. That's okay. C coming in is 3 plus 0, and going out is 2 plus 1. So my conservation is satisfied. Okay, the next step then is to replace the demands back on this graph right here and make sure everything is okay. So here's my graph. So I'll just, with my original nodes copied over. Okay, I copy over all the flows. And I replace my demands, which are 3, 4. Oops, those are negatives because they're supplies, right? And then C is 2, and D is 5. So now the only thing left to do is to check our demand constraints, just make sure everything is okay. Here I've got a supply of 3, and going out is 3. Here I have a supply of 4, coming in is 0, going out is 0 plus 4. So both of these, my demand constraints are satisfied for each of these. Okay, here for C, coming in is 3 plus 0, going out is 1, 3 minus 1 is 2, and that's what's used up right there at C. Here's D, coming in is 1 plus 4, that gives me 5, and that's what I need to use at C. So I'm done computing the network flow with demands for this example right here. I'm going to take this same example that I have here, and then in the next clip, solve network flow with demands and lower bounds.